Hi guys, Alex here. Welcome back to Shook Unscripted, and I am super excited. I've got a couple of stories that I wanted to talk about with you guys today. We're going to start off basically doing one of Arshan Topless World updates, but we're going to talk about this recent drama with her being like stuck in the apartment. And it was this whole thing from her live this morning. We're also going to talk about the mysterious illness that has befallen our beauty. Things have seemingly taken a turn for the strange. And then later on in the video, I wanted to quickly discuss this clip that I found on a Eugenia clip channel where her mom actually addresses if she worries for Eugenia. And I just thought I would share it with you guys, because we have followed her on the channel for quite a while now. All that and more coming up on today's edition of Shook Unscripted. Let's just get right into it. I mean, shall we? All right, you guys. So the past 24 hours in Shantopolis has not really been that dramatic, but it has been quite a bit strange. And we do have two stories to talk about today. So the first one that I wanted to talk about, she went live today and the stream was called I Am So Sick. And she came on and she was hacking and she didn't seem like she was in the best space physically, but her attitude was actually seemingly bright and cheery, or at least as bright and cheery as you can expect her to be. She was talking about how Salah was out doing quote business. I mean, we can only guess what he is actually doing. I do wonder if he has some sort of other job that he goes to on the regular aside from this perfume business. Maybe she is keeping that from the public because she doesn't want people to contact it. And to be perfectly honest, I feel like that would be a smart thing to do if he does have something else going on. But if it is the perfume business, I just find it to be a little bit fishy based on what we have seen, of course, with the Instagram and the fact that nobody is able to verify these products because he does not ship internationally. So during the video, she talks about how Salah's away on business and the door is locked. But not only does he have the door locked from the outside, supposedly Foodie is locked inside. She's locked inside the apartment with no way out. Take a look at this comment that a concerned fan left her, and she kind of verifies the situation. Laura says, "Does Salah really lock you in when he's out? Can you unlock the door from the inside if you don't have a key? Fire safety is important." To which Foodie replies, "LMAO, yeah, but just because he worries if the door is left unlocked and the only way to lock it is with the key, I know you are seriously concerned, so I don't mean to laugh. I'm okay though, but let's just like dissect this for a little bit." I mean, she is almost 40 years old. And she's living in this foreign country and she's stuck inside this apartment. You know, of course, a fire could happen and that could end up being very dangerous. But aside from that, there's also just the fact that what is she supposed to do all day? I know she had talked about now she is sick. So of course, she's not going to be wandering around town. But this seems like this was a regular occurrence even when she was there the previous time. I do wonder, like, is there a place that they can get a second key made? Why wouldn't he leave the key for her? Especially if she's going to be staying there all day just in case something happened. Not to mention how controlling that is. Like, I just can't imagine being stuck in an apartment, unable to leave. Just the psychological aspect of that for me, would be too much, knowing that I'm not able to leave, knowing that I can't go anywhere, knowing that how is she supposed to get her food delivery too if she can't open the door at all? Something seems very strange here. I feel like there's a couple of things going on here. I mean, for one, maybe Salah thinks that he can't really control this woman. So this is his way of exercising his control while he brings this woman food. I mean, if you really peel back the curtain, what is going on here? He continues to bring her so much food. And as we have seen from the previous Kuwait arc, lots of Pepsi. I did notice some chocolate, lots of chocolate that she claims is for Salah in the grocery haul. Yeah, right. But he's keeping this woman in this apartment and feeding her. It does start to get a little bit worrisome. Although Chantal seems to be perfectly happy and content, I do have to say that bit, she seems perfectly happy with this arrangement. She's not feeling so well, so it is what it is. She doesn't seem to think that this is any sort of big deal, and she is not rushing to get a second key made or anything like that. And then there's also another possibility that she is not telling the truth about this. Now, why exactly would she do that? Why would she make up this ridiculous lie? Of course, when she comes on with Salah later, because he always comes on with her, I mean, people in the chat are probably going to bring this situation up, so it's going to reach Salah's ears. So I don't know if she would want to come up with a lie like that, or maybe she has him in on everything that she is doing now. That wouldn't surprise me either. But the reason that she would make some of this up is because of the situation with BBJ. You know, everyone is super upset with her at this point. She has been canceled like 10 times over. Maybe she wants people to feel worried for her in this situation. It wouldn't be the first time that someone acted out in a way wanting people to worry about them, especially on the internet where people just crave attention like that. Chantal did actually post a grocery haul today. Like we said, supposedly Salah got a bunch of sweets, right? Does anyone believe that? I mean, she even tells on herself in the video saying, you know, I don't think that many people are going to believe this, but this is 100% the truth. And then she also posted a video on her couples vlog. I just skimmed through both of these videos. They're not really interesting to me. And just judging by the reception, I don't think that they're very interesting to many other people as well. I mean, she knows, and that's why she did that live stream the other day. She knows that she needs to generate the drama. So the live stream she put out, not yesterday, but the day before, where she said that she hates the community. She needs to generate that drama or nobody's going to watch. And I think that she kind of hit like an all-time high with maybe the Cuba rage or, you know, the situation with Natter. And we talked about this in the past. She will be unable to kind of top that drama. And it has gone like so high. Is it only downhill from here? I mean, when she did initially put on the hijab and state her intentions, her journey to the Middle East, that definitely got people interested again, because that's not something you see every day. And we had seen Chantal for the past 2 years just be an absolute mess. So to see someone like her, it was almost like she had done a complete 180 overnight. Like, she was not very modest. So the shock factor was definitely there. But I also wanted to talk about her sickness. So I have seen this going around the community, specifically Skinny Queen Productions had a community tab post saying Tiger Talks made a video addressing Foodie Beauty having possible MERS, and she was saying she was sick yesterday. So this was even from yesterday before she came on. I've seen a couple channels do videos on this, including Tiger Talks. So basically, MERS is passed primarily to people from infected camels. And Foodie Beauty, just 4 days ago on March 5th, posted a live stream hugging camels in the Kuwait desert. And you can see her getting really up close and personal with the camels. If she was going to catch something, she would probably have caught it. I mean, she got really up in that camel. But this is just speculation. This is just conjecture. I mean, she did just go on a plane and travel all the way from Canada to the Middle East, 2 different planes, big airports with lots of people. So it could be that she has gotten any type of flu, any type of cold or COVID. I mean, that's definitely a possibility as well. If I was her, I probably would just get a test, because why not? But you guys know Chantal, she is not the most responsible person, so you can't even expect her to do something like that. Okay, so I have been following Eugenia for quite a while now. We've talked about the infamous diaper saga, people wanting her banned from TikTok. You know, I have never been one to support deplatforming. And speaking of deplatforming, we did talk about the situation with Jacqueline Glenn, where she had people sign a petition trying to get her removed from the internet. But all of that is ancient history. I did see a new channel pop up, Eugenia Twitch Clips, which actually really helps me out, because I don't have the time to watch her Twitch channel, especially keeping up with our girls at the same time. It is just too much. But this particular clip definitely caught my eye. It is her playing a video game with her mom. Someone in the side chat sends like a Twitch super chat, whatever that's called. They want to get Eugenia's mom's opinion. Is she worried about her? And, you know, her response may shock you.
Dad, does her weight not concern you? I'm so curious how you see her. Good luck on the dancing. You'll be great.
All right, let's do some dancing. Thanks for bits. Fez, this is
fluid. I'm sorry. I don't know how.
That's okay. Fez, you alright?
She ignored chat. Fez, no, my mom's not concerned about my weight. No, that was their question.
I've known her my whole life. I know her blood work and her doctor's appointments and everything check out good. I'm not concerned.
There's your answer. I think she just didn't hear you. She wasn't trying to be rude at all, guys. My mom is a very nice, good person.
She was watching the setting screen.
Yeah, she was watching the setting screen.
So there you have it, folks. Her mom has been with her to the doctor's office and everything is just perfectly okay. And she's not concerned at all. I do remember in the past when Jacqueline Glenn and that whole situation where she actually got her admitted to the hospital, she did talk about her family and how they just kind of brushed this under the rug. It wasn't something that they wanted to talk about. You could definitely hear from the mom in her tone of voice that she was kind of annoyed that this was even coming up. Maybe they don't want to put that kind of thing online. But I just find the whole thing to be strange. Take a look at this comment. Someone says, the way she's smiling and acting so happy that her mom gets to tell them all that she agrees she's fine. Pathetic, as if that makes a difference. Just proves Jacqueline was right. Whatever it is going on behind the scenes with Eugenia, I do hope that someday she does reach out and get help from somebody. But it really does open your eyes when you hear from her mom directly saying that she doesn't see that anything is wrong here. It just feels like an extremely concerning situation, especially when you take into account, I mean, a lot of people, when they are in recovery, of course, you have to do it for yourself when it comes to recovering over anything. You have to do it for yourself, but also one of the big strengths that people can have is a supportive family or a supported loved one or partner if they are with you on this journey. And even sometimes they can push you. Now, they can't force you to get better, but they can definitely push you to get better. And so for her to not have that at all, it's not something I'm even really used to seeing. It's quite alarming. All right, you guys, that's going to be it for today's video. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. And I will, of course, catch you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.